We've got another WVD video for you at the Azure Academy, and today we want to answer the question of how we can save money on WVD and put the ability for our users to power on and off their VMs without having to bother IT. So join us for the next few minutes as we create a Windows Virtual Desktop power management system. I'm Dean Cifola, and this is the Azure Academy. If you want to master the Azure Cloud, you can start right now by clicking the subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss anything. So here in the WVD admin portal, I've got a personal host pool, and that's set up currently with one virtual machine. And if our user who owns this tries to log in, they're going to have a problem. And that problem is that this VM is currently unavailable. Now, why would that be? So if we click on our VM, we can see that the current status of this VM is that it is stopped. So I either have to wait for the scaling tool schedule to turn on my VM for me, or I've got to ask somebody in IT, can you power on my VM because it's currently off. Now, if IT isn't available, it's in the middle of the night, or you've got some executive who wants to log onto their system, this is obviously a problem. Now, today there's a bunch of ways, of course, that you could handle this. You could give people access to the Azure portal, which isn't always recommended. You could put in a support ticket, which can take a while, or we can do what I'm going to show you today. So here's my mobile phone, and if I open up one of my folders where I've got my WVD client, that's the one on the right, I've also got another one here for WVD Power On. So if I open that app, see what we're loading here is a Microsoft Power app, and we're signed in. And boy, look at that. What I can do is just power on my VM. So I'll click power on. And when I do, the VM is starting up. By creating a power app, I was able to give this ability right to one of the users who owns this particular VM. So now they can turn it on and off whenever they want. So now that our VM's up and running, we can just log in. So I'll go back to my mobile phone and open the RD client. And when I do, I don't have anything set up here, so I've got to register for this first by adding a workspace. And now I can type in my email, or I can provide a URL. And when I type in my email address, I've got another problem, which is that no workspaces are found. Now, I know that that's not true. I do have a workspace because I've used WVD a lot of times. So this is the second problem that we'll address in a few minutes. So a few days ago on Twitter, I saw this post from Tom Hickling, who is one of the Microsoft WVD Global Black Belts. And this caught my attention because of this very scenario. And so I clicked on the link here to aka.ms/WVD auto. And that brings you over to Tom's blog, where he gives you all of the directions for how to do this. And this is the process that we're going to walk through today. So step number one, we need to go to flow.microsoft.com, and then you just sign in with your regular credentials. And then over on the left, we'll go to My Flows. And you can see I've already got two flows here, one for power on, one for power off. And that's the first thing that we need to create. And we do that by going to New, Instant from Blank. Then we have to give our flow a name. I'll call mine WVD Power On, and we'll select a power app as our trigger and hit create. So we're going to click here to add a new step, and then we're going to type in HTTP, and then I chose HTTP premium here. And then we have our method, and then we're going to select post, which means that we're going to use the ARM APIs here. So we need to go to another doc. And inside all of the Azure docs, you can find these references that'll give you the API and PowerShell and other kind of commands. And at the bottom here, we have the start API, which I'll click on that. And then we can just copy this code, and I'll just paste that into a notepad here just to make it easy. We need to change some of the text here to add our subscription ID, resource group name, and then the name of the virtual machine that we want to start. And there we go. And I'll copy all of that code and go back to our flow and put that here in the URI. Now we need to connect it to Azure, and we can do this in the advanced options. And we'll select the authentication here by Active Directory OAuth. Back in the Azure portal, we'll need to grab our Azure Active Directory tenant ID, which we can find by going to Azure Active Directory and then clicking to copy the tenant ID. And back in the flow, we'll put that in the tenant box. For our audience, and this is where we're directing the API call, and that's going to be to management.azure.com. And now we need to set up a client ID. Now, in Azure Active Directory terms, this is an application, and it's this application that we're going to grant the permissions to be able to do the start and stop. And under app registrations, I've already got one here called Test Power App, but I'll create a new one for you. and I'll call it the WVD Power Trigger. And this is only going to work with a single tenant, so I can leave this middle section alone. And then for the redirect URI, so I'll just put in here msazureacademy.com/WVD Power Trigger. And no, this does not need to be a valid URL in case you were wondering. And I'll click the register button, and that has now created an Azure AD application. And we want to copy here the application or client ID, and we'll put that in our flow. And now we need to generate a secret. So we'll go back to Azure AD on the left, go to certificates and secrets, and at the bottom, create a new client secret. And I'll just call this the WVD Power Trigger secret. And then you can set how long it will be before this secret expires, 1 year, 2 years, or never. In this case, I'll just set 1 year and click add. So very important here, we do need to copy this secret, because once we click out of this screen, then this secret is going to be locked and we won't be able to get back to it. So copy that into your notepad. And now we need to assign permissions. So I'm going to go to my resource group where my target VMs are located, which is MSAA-WVD, and I'll go to access control and I'll set a role assignment, and I'll make this a virtual machine contributor, and I'll search for my WVD Power Trigger and then hit save. And if we scroll down, there we've got our virtual machine contributor rights. So I've got that copied, and we'll paste that right here into our flow, and then we'll click the save button. And that step is complete. Now you can additionally set up a notification trigger that this whole process completed successfully. So you could set up mobile notifications, you could set up a post to Microsoft Teams, or just a general email. So any way that you like to do it. And since I'm setting this up for the user Nova, because this is his personal VM, I'll put his email address in here. And I'll give it a subject of WVD power on complete. And the body says your WVD VM power on has completed and you can sign in. So I'll hit save for that. Now over in the top right, we have the flow checker, which will just verify that you have no errors or warnings in your process. And then I'll hit save. And you can test this flow right from here before we go on to the next step of creating the Power app. But I'm actually going to go back because we want to set up another new flow. And this will be for the power off. So we'll go back and set a new instant from blank again. We'll call this flow WVD power off, set our Power app trigger and hit create. And then we'll follow the same steps in the process. We'll add a new step. This will be HTTP, and I'll choose the HTTP premium here. For our method, it'll again be a post. And for our URI, we'll go back to the Azure documentation. And this one we want to be the deallocate API, which I'll copy over to my notepad. And I'll make the updates to call my specific VM. And I'm just plugging in the same information, my subscription ID, the resource group name, and then the name of the virtual machine itself. And you can see this API is going to be calling the deallocate command. So we'll copy all of that back to our flow. And then we'll choose the advanced options using Active Directory OAuth for our authentication. Back in Azure Active Directory, we'll grab our tenant ID and paste that into our flow. And then under our app registrations, we'll copy our application client ID into the flow as well. And finally, we'll place our secret here. So we've got the exact same setup as before, just calling the deallocate API, and we'll save that. And we'll add another new step for an email notification. And I've set my subject and body to tell Nova that his VM has powered off, and we'll hit save. We'll do our flow checker and everything looks good, so we'll hit save. So a very easy process to set up our power on and power off triggers. And let's do a test here. Since our VM is currently powered on, we'll run the power off trigger and click run flow. And then we can click here to watch the run. And our flow is currently running. So let's go and check on our virtual machine. And our VM status is currently updating. And if we hit refresh, we are now deallocating. Now we move on to creating the application that the user is going to interact with. And this is going to be at powerapps.microsoft.com. And I've got my app that I've already created, and I'll create a new one for you so you can see the whole process. So we'll go on the left here to create, and we'll create an app from a blank canvas. And I'll call this the WVD Power Trigger, and I'll be selecting this for a phone and hit create. So at the top, we'll go to insert, and I'll insert a button here and position them wherever I like. And I'll rename the text over here on the right to WVD Power On. And then a little further down, we'll click to change the color of the button, and I'll make this a green. And then we'll go to click on our other button and rename this one. We'll call this WVD Power Off, and we'll set the color for this one to be red. Now you can make this look however you like and add whatever additional text you want, or we can add some graphics and then go over here on the left to the media button. And I'll click to upload some graphics, and I'll add the WVD logo, and then I'll go back and add another one, and I'll add my new Azure Academy logo. Then we just have to drag them into place. So at the top now, I'll click on Actions, and we want to add the Power Automate function, which is going to join our flows here. So we want to add this to our Power On button, and then we want to add our WVD Power On. And once that's complete, we just need to close our parentheses at the top. And then you can see that the Power On Run trigger will equal true, and we'll just hit Enter for that. And our Power On is complete. So now let's do the Power Off. We'll click Power Automate. Select our Power Off flow. We'll add the closing parenthesis and hit Enter. And we are done. So at this point, we need to save this. So I'll go to File and click Save As. And we want to be sure that we're saving this to the cloud and not to our local computer. We'll leave the name as WVD Power Trigger, and in the bottom right corner, we'll hit Save. And our Power App is now saved. Now we can share this right over to Nova. Now, Nova's not going to need to make any edits here, so we don't have to check the co-owner button. We'll just click share, and that is on its way to Nova. So if you had 5 users, you'd have to map the same process for the 5 different users to the 5 different VMs and then share them with the users appropriately. Back in the Azure portal now, I've got my iPhone up here again. We'll go into the App Store and we'll search for Microsoft Power Apps. And then we'll download and install that. And now that that's downloaded, we'll go ahead and launch that and sign in with our Nova credentials. And you log on here to the My Apps screen. And of course, Nova has not created his own Power App. So we need to go at the top to All Apps, and then we can see the WVD Power Trigger. So we'll click on that. And now we need to sign in and grant permission here. And at the bottom, we'll hit the Accept and Connect. And we are now signed in. So we'll click the Allow button. There is our application. And as you can see over in the background, our VM is currently in a stopped state. So we'll click the Power On trigger, and our VM is starting up. So I'd like you to tell me in the comments what you think of the new banner that we have for our YouTube channel. And if you have any suggestions for new videos, give me those in the comments down below. Now let's slide out to go back. And now we want to add this to our home screen so we don't have to open Power App and sign in. We want all this to kind of happen for us. So we'll click the 3 dots and then click Pin to Home. And then on an iPhone, we'll click to open the share tray. And then we scroll down just a little bit and tap on the Add to Home screen. And then we just click Add. Now I've added that. And of course, I can just tap on it again to get right back to where I was. It'll launch the Power App in the background. Load my Power Trigger app, and I'm ready to power on or off my virtual machine. Now, I did say we had a second problem to solve today, and that was that our RD client were not signed in. And we go to add a new workspace and type in our email. And when we do, it says that there are no workspaces found. We could put in the URL, but it's not something that people are likely to know or remember on their own. We want to make this setup as easy as possible. So to do this, we need to add some stuff to our DNS. Now I've got a link for this right in the video description. Now over in the Azure portal is where I have my public DNS zone, and I'll go and add a new record. And this record will be called underscore MSRADC, and the type will be a text record. We'll leave the time to live at 1 hour, which is also 3600 seconds. And we'll add our value of our feed discovery URL, and we'll hit OK. And you can see our record has been added. Now, if you're like most organizations, you would have an internal and external DNS like mine are, then you should add the feed discovery to both places. And here's the DNS on my domain controller. I'll right click on my zone and go to add an other new record. We'll scroll down and add a text record, and we'll add the exact same thing, underscore MSRADC, and then we'll add our feed discovery as our text. back on my iPhone, if I add my email address now, the DNS has been updated, and it searches, and now it finds my feed. So I can launch my personal desktop here, give it my credentials, and then click continue. So let me go through the process for the end of the day now. I'm finished doing all of my work. I'll just click on start, go to do my sign out process, and then I'll go back to my Power app. Then we'll click our WVD Power Off button, and we can see in the background that our VM is deallocating. So I hope this video has been helpful for you to give your users back some of the control, take some of the pressure off of IT, and help you save some money in the process. So if you learned something new today, go ahead and click the thumbs up, as well as subscribe to the Azure Academy if you haven't done that yet. And we just want to help you to master all of Azure. So if there's something that we haven't covered in a video, please give me some comments so we can add those videos for you to help you out. And if you want to keep on learning, over on the top right, we've got our latest video, as well as another one on the bottom that we picked out just for you so that you can keep growing in your Azure skills. Thanks again for joining us this week, and we will see you next week at the same time. Happy learning.